Gentlemen, want to talk to you today about the pressures of life and the temptation to quit, to lose control. I know that's a temptation for every guy because I talk to a lot of men and I myself am a man, and pressure can build and build and build and build, that not so much you want to quit as much as you just want to lose it. You just want to hit something, kick something, shout at something, cuss at something, slap something, like just absolutely let all self-control go and just blow your top, which can lead to a place of quitting. When a person quits physically, they have already, sometimes several days prior, quit mentally. So what I want to tell you is found in Joel chapter 2, verses 12 through 13, where God is instructing the priests, and he says this, "Tear your hearts, but not your garments." So here's what he was saying, and here's what's understood in the Old Testament. When a priest would, and basically anybody, would tear their outer garments, it was a sign of this overwhelming season of mourning. It was an outward expression of an inward decision to quit. Basically, I quit, I can't take this, I don't want to do this, this is unfair, this is not right. And so they would tear their garments and throw them off as a way of saying, I'm walking away, I'm not going to engage. I have seen male after male do this in marriages. It's called divorce. It gets difficult, it's too much pressure, and they just go, you know what, I'm out, I'm not in this marriage anymore, I want a divorce. Sometimes worse than that, they don't file the paperwork, they don't have a divorce, but they check out emotionally, they check out mentally, they're not in the marriage anymore, they're not there. They check out emotionally on their children, they're still physically there, but they're not there. And so what I wanna kind of challenge myself and everybody, because we all have pressures of life, we all understand what I'm saying, and there is this thing in us that if we don't wanna lose control, we sure wanna remove ourselves from the pressure. As prophet, priest, king, and warrior, we are not allowed nor given the opportunity to tear our garments, to have an outward expression of losing it. One of the fruits of the Spirit is self-control. So you have it, and I understand that pressure, but never, ever, ever, ever lose it in front of the people you lead. Don't allow that inward battle to manifest itself into the physical where you cause your wife, your children, your friends, the people around you to feel like, oh my gosh, this guy is a ticking time bomb. He could lose it. He could quit on us at any moment. Now look, Joel says, tear your hearts. What does that mean? That means by all means, I'm not asking you to fake it. In no way am I asking you to do that. What I am saying is in your heart, feel the pain, because the pressure of pain, the pressure of betrayal, the pressure of a lost deal, the pressure of friends stabbing you in the back, the pressure of life is a real thing. Feel that pain. Run to the Father first. Go and pray, because here's what you need to overcome this. You need peace. And a lot of people believe peace is an emotion. Peace is not an emotion. Peace is a person. His name is Jesus, the Prince of Peace. So you need to run to him, get in his presence. And look, if that's not working, like I'm praying, I'm listening to worship music, but I still, man, I want to lose it. Call a brother, call somebody you're walking with, call your mentor, get in their space. So that the grace of God can fall on you. They can lay hands on you and pray for you. They can talk you through the mental struggle that you're going through so that you don't quit. This is what I tell guys all the time. Never quit anything when it's dark. Never quit anything when it's hard. Never quit anything when it's tough. If you're in a business deal, if you're an entrepreneur, if you're doing something and it's hard, because it's going to be hard, don't quit on it while it's hard. Let everything kind of mellow out. Get some momentum going. And then if you believe, you know what, this is not really what I want to do, then okay, let's have a discussion. But when you're deep in the pit and the emotions are high, never, ever quit. Never, ever quit, because you will make an emotional decision that potentially you could regret for the rest of your life. So as the instruction coming from the word of the Lord to all of us as men, prophet, priest, king, and warrior, never tear your garments. Never, ever lose self-control in front of those you lead and you love. It doesn't mean you fake it. It means you maintain self-control. You know who you are and whose you are. When it's tough, go to the Father, run to the Prince of Peace. If that's not working as quickly as you need it to, find a brother, call them, because I believe in you. You can do it. Christ lives in you, so greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The enemy is what's bringing the pressure. Jesus wants to bring you life and peace and joy. Just know this, there's no weapon formed against you that will ever prosper, but it does not say no weapon will ever be formed. It just says that the weapon that's formed will not prosper against you. Walk in the truth. The truth will absolutely set you free if you remain. That verse says, remain in my truth. So there's this constant remaining to build momentum to come out of that. Do me a favor, guys, don't quit. Do not quit. The reward on the other side of not quitting is worth it. But if you quit before the reward happens, then you will live in regret forever. Here's what I say. It's hurting already. You're in pain already. Go through the pain to at least get a reward. Don't go through more pain just to live in regret. And that's because I love you and I believe in you and I walk the same walk as you do. There are times I have in my mind, I don't need to do this. I don't have to do this. I don't even want to do this. And the pressure surmounts and I have to reorder myself, get in front of my dad in heaven, play some worship music, go for a run, do something to clear my head. So take my advice, walk this journey with me. I hope I dropped some cool wisdom on you, but just know this, do not quit. You're a prophet, priest, king, and warrior in the earth. You are created to rule and reign and to create safe places for those you love and you lead, and you can do it. I love you, gentlemen. Thank you for being with me today.